Hi everyone, welcome back to Code Android. In part 1 of this tutorial, we have created the views needed for custom view. If you haven't watched that video, I strongly recommend to watch that before continuing this video. In it, I am creating an inflator object using the context value inflator equals to context.getSystemService context.layoutInflatorService as layoutInflator. Value view equals to inflator dot inflate. Here we need to pass the layout id r dot layout dot my custom view with this and true as parameters. Private variable autocomplete text view, type of autocomplete text view. We are getting an error because without initialization we shouldn't create a variable. So I am assigning the autocomplete text view to a view in the constructor. So it will not show error. Autocomplete text view equals to view.findViewById. Here we need to give the id r.id.autocompleteTextView. It will search this view for id autocompleteTextView and initialize that view to this variable. Private var listView, type of listView. Assigning the listView. Sorry, I forgot to create the listView in my custom view layout. So create a list view with width as match parent, height as wrap content. I am giving divider null and divider height as 5 dp. Assigning id as list view. Give id list view here. Let's do the same for text view title and image view add. Setting autocomplete text view's threshold to 1. To store selected items, we need a mutable list. So, creating a mutable list in the name of selected items and assigning it to ArrayList. We need another mutable list for storing the suggestion. So, duplicating this and renaming it to all items. Set an onClick listener for add button. Here, I am storing the content of autocomplete text view into a variable called selected string. Also, I am using the trim method to remove beginning and end spaces of the text. When selected string dot is empty is true, then showing a toast as please enter data. Selected string is already contained in the selected items list, then showing a toast as item already added. Else, adding the selected string into selected items list with the position 0, because the added item needs to show as the top element. Trim is returning character sequence. To convert it into string, I am using toString method. Now we need to create an adapter for the list view. Inner class my custom view adapter extends array adapter of string. Click on the error symbol and select a constructor with mutable list. I am going to use resource and object inside the class. Because of that, I am declaring those as a variable. Creating an inflator to inflate the list view items. Overriding getCount method. It will return number of items available in list view. So, return object.size. Overriding getView. This will return the view for the list item, inflating the layout called resource with inflator and storing it into view object. Return the view object. I forgot to add the ID for list item text view. Adding the ID for the text view and initializing it. In adapter, we need to explicitly give the type. I'm initializing the delete image view. Assigning the text view text as selected item by getting the position from the list. Setting onClick listener for the image view. Here we need to remove the item from the selected item list using the position. Creating a function for refreshing the list. Inside, I am passing argument clear data because once we add the autocomplete text view data into selected item, then we need to clear autocomplete text view. While deleting, we shouldn't clear. So I kept this flag. We need to set the adapter for list view by creating my custom view adapter with context, my custom view item layout, and selected items mutable list. If clear data is set to true, then I am setting the autocomplete text view as empty. This set list view height based on children will set the list view height. Why I am doing this? If we use this view inside scroll view, then the scrolling of list view will not work properly. So I am calculating the list view height manually using this method. Calling refresh data method with true as parameter on adding an item and with false while removing item. Creating setData method for setting the suggestions. Here I need to update autocomplete text view adapter. So autocomplete text view dot set adapter array adapter of context layout file android.r.layout.simple-list-item1 and all items as parameter. Creating another method for setting the title text. Also, we need a method for getting selected data. So, I am naming it as getSelectedData and it will return mutable list. To avoid null, adding double exclamation after objects. Now we have completed the code for custom view. Open activity_main.xml, change the root layout to relative layout. Inside, we need to add our custom view. We can able to see our custom view as a suggestion. So select it and give width as match parent and height as wrap content. Assigning ID so that I can access it from Kotlin. Center vertical true. Adding a button to see the result. I am aligning it to the bottom of the screen using align parent bottom attribute and setting text, background color, etc. Also aligning the custom view above the button. Open mainActivity.kt. We need a mutable list with the suggestions. So, variable list type of mutable list and assign it to ArrayList. Add the suggestions. CustomView.setData as list. Setting title as languages. Also setting onClickListener for submit button. On click of submit button, creating a toast to show the result. Let's run it. We can able to see the custom view and we are getting the suggestions. But the background for the list item is missing, so I am adding it into the parent. Also removing layout above from the autocomplete text view. Let's run it. Now it is working fine. It's not accepting the same value as we expected. Remove also working fine. One issue is the text is overlapping with the background. We'll add some padding to avoid it. Also, add padding for the autocomplete text view. Let's run it. You can see, as we expected, the layout is working fine. If we need to use the custom view more than one places, just add these lines in that file with the different ID. That's all for this tutorial, guys. If you have any doubt, please put it in the comment section. I will try to answer it. Also, if you have any specific video, let me know in the comment section. I will try to do that. Hope you like it. I will see you on my next video. Have a good day.